Hi, good morning. I'd like to welcome you to Poem Praise 2, and I have been compelled to entitle this, I Am Not My Hair. And here's a little musical interlude for you. And it goes like this.
I am not my hair. It's time for us to redefine who we be. You can shut it off like a South African beauty. Got it on lock like Bob Marley. You can rock it straight like Oprah Winfrey. You can stop what's on your head, it's what's underneath, and say, hey,
I am not my head.
Now, here on Poem Praise 2, I'm about to get ready to just let you know in regards. I'm going to just do a little free flow on I Am Not My Hair. And the reason why I'm doing this is because, you see how right now it's all curly right now. You know, that's just a little bit of some products. And, you know, you could certainly use baking soda and water to take it back to the natural curly state. Now, don't get me wrong, we do have your ponytails that you can add to your hair, and you do have your wigs that you could put on your hair, and you could certainly have straight. But I know us as a people, we have hair that defines gravity. I certainly heard that, and I like that option that we can have it stick straight up. We can certainly, thanks to Madam C.J. Walker, we could add some chemicals and make it straight. But what has compelled me to do this is I heard from someone who's not of the same culture as I am. I'm not going to put no names out there, put them on blast. But she came to me and said that I'm jealous that you're able to have your hair be curly. You know, I ain't come with a quick response, because sometimes when people talk to you, a response is not required. And sometimes they're not actually telling you about you. They're telling you about themselves. So, you know, I thought about it for a second, and I'm thinking to myself, jealous. Jealousy turns to envy. Envy turns to hate. Okay. In regards to, so you know, I gave her some advice in regards to what type of chemicals she can use. It's possibly rolling the hair, using a setting lotion, using something in regards to taking time with your hair if you do not like the way it is, to actually bring across a different appearance of how it looks. And then I actually am compelled to say, okay, now us out there who have hair. Sometimes you can use the straight hair, but if you want to see the open enemy, just sometimes go back to the natural state and see how individuals may look at you, or how they may act towards you. And it should be nothing in regards to your hair. We're certainly defined by who we are on the inside. Not so much that I ain't gonna feel right unless I get my hair done, unless it's straight like butter. Okay. Who has their hair that's not defying gravity, that's always straight? I don't know. It certainly is in regards to appearance, but I'm just talking to all the women out there. What in this world has happened where we don't like our hair? Or we don't like the... Now, I'm not talking to my natural beauties out there, the ones who actually do it natural and you have no problem with it. I'm talking about the ones who act like they don't feel right unless they have the straightness. They don't actually have a good positive self-image unless they have the straightness. It's if you're hating what is naturally yours, and it may not be from you, it may be from mama, who when you was young straightened it, or it may be from grandma who actually straightened it, or it may be something in regards to, because when we start having our daughters be raised and we're making them start to dislike their hair, that's dealing with the self-image and is going on the inside in regards to, okay, I gotta have it straight. I gotta have a flat iron, or you know, there's different types. Don't get me wrong or misquoted in regards to what I'm talking about. I'm just talking about versatility is a good thing. But when we get to the point as a people where we're constantly going to the hair store, I got to get some extensions, or I got to go to the hair store, or it ain't right, I'm having a bad hair day because it's afro. Wait a minute. Where do we come from? Wait a minute. It's not all like that. I understand you have your personal grooming preferences in regards to what you have to do in regards to us as being women. But the reason why I'm saying, wait a minute, I'm just a little bit upset in regards to how we got little girls who feel that it ain't gonna be right unless it's long. You're a beauty, whether it's short, or whether it's long, whether it's medium size, whether it's straight, or whether it's curly. Don't get it twisted in regards to how we wear our hair. Don't think because I have an afro that you could come to me and maybe treat me a certain way or talk to me a certain way. Don't get it twisted in regards to what's on the inside just because what you're looking at on the outside. See the color of my skin? Yeah, you might have the little stereotypes you may have in regards to what you think you know about me on the inside, but don't try to judge a book by the cover. You want to know what's on the inside, you got to ask questions, do a little research, a little history, and know something. Know something. That's all this is about, is just know something. If you want to see it, if you want to hear what I'm talking about, do a revolt, do a change. Go on and try it for yourself. Because see, I'm not going to come to you and tell you something without me trying it for myself first. All right? I already did this and had the ponytails. You know, you see my channel, the different hairstyles I have, the different hairstyles. And I can do that as a woman. Yes, we can. But in regards to the world and how they might appear and look at us, as a particular people, because we are particular. Yes, we are. we're one of a kind. Yes, we are. So I'm just letting you try it for yourself and see. If you just all of a sudden just come and you go to work and all of a sudden your hair just looking different. Or you just go to the grocery store, because it's everywhere. The grocery store, the banks, schools, everywhere. And just see the actual different reaction you may feel, or the different reactions that may come your way from other cultures regarding if you're not in the norm to be different. Okay? That's all I'm saying to you. And I certainly want you to do that. And this is just a challenge to all our beauty queens, all our gods and goddesses. It's just a challenge, just challenge, and certainly do it like a scientific type thing. I'm going to make a hypothesis in regards to before I do this, and then I'm going to actually write down within my memory bank the actual stats that I come up with. Because, yeah, I just know that this is not just happening to me. And I can't be the only one who's got the eyes open and seeing this. But certainly if your eye is closed and you can't see what I'm seeing, this is just the activation to your eye to open it up. Because, yeah, it's 2017. It's real. I'm trying to tell you, this ain't fake what I'm talking about. It's going on. So that's all I wanted to do, was give you a good morning. And I am not my hair. So we're certainly going to end it on a musical note. For sure. All right, now, be blessed.